This is Kevin Patton with another study tip for human anatomy and physiology. This time I'm going to continue where I left off in a previous presentation in which I provided a shortcut to learning the bones and bone features of the vertebrate skeleton by focusing on the meaning of their names. In our previous episode, I advised that the best way and the quickest way to learn a long list of specific skeletal features, like those illustrated here, is to think of the human skeleton as having geographic features like those on the surface of the earth. If you know what a river is, then finding a specific river in a map or satellite image is not that hard. You just ignore all the bumps and holes and look only at the sharp squiggly lines. Likewise, in the skeleton, if you know that a foramen is a hole, then you can ignore the bumps and depressions and only look at the holes until you find the one that you are looking for. And knowing the meanings of these descriptive terms also helps you remember these features more easily. In this presentation, I'm going to very quickly run through the meaning of each major descriptive term used to describe various geographical features of the skeleton. This is so that you form a picture in your mind and can get started learning skeletal features right away. Some skeletal features are the outer edges or boundaries of a bone. A straight edge or boundary of a bone is called a border. Here we can see the medial border and the lateral border of the scapula or shoulder blade. An edge of a flat bone or flat area can also be called a margin, as in the margins around the socket or orbit of the eye. An angle is an inside or outside corner along the boundary of a bone. A notch is a V-like cut out of the margin or edge of a flat area. It looks a little like a bite has been taken out of the bone. The main or central portion of a bone is called the body of the bone, as in the main part of the lower jawbone, the mandible, identified here. In a long bone, the shaft portion is also called the body of the bone. The head of a bone is a distinct epiphysis or end piece on a long bone, separated from the shaft by a narrowed portion or neck. The neck is a narrowed portion of a bone, usually at the base of a head. The neck of the femur or thigh bone can be seen here. The long bone of the arm, the humerus, has an anatomical neck where the head joins the body of the bone. But there is also a narrowing below that where fractures may occur called the surgical neck. A ramus or ramus is a curved portion of a bone, like a ram's horn. Here we see the part of the lower jawbone, the mandible, that curves upward. The word ramus literally means branch. We often identify features on the surface of a bone. A facet, or facet, for example, is a flat surface that forms a joint with another facet, or flat bone. Facet literally means little face. A fossa is a depression. A fossa is often an indentation that receives an articulating bone. The word fossa literally means ditch. An elongated depression or groove may be called a sulcus. The word sulcus literally means trench. A crest is a moderately raised ridge. It is generally a site for muscle attachment. The term crest literally means tuft or comb. A line is similar to a crest, but not raised as much. It is often rather faint, as in these lines seen along the back of the femur and along the side of the skull. A process is the general name for any bone projection or significantly raised area. A sharp pointed process may be called a spine or spinous process. A spine can be similar to a crest, but raised more. A spine is for muscle attachment. Spine literally means thorn. A condyle is a rounded bump. It usually fits into a fossa on another bone to form a joint. Condyle literally means knuckle. An epicondyle is a bump near a condyle. An epicondyle often gives the appearance of a bump on a bump. An epicondyle is usually for muscle attachment, not for direct connection to another bone. Epicondyle literally means upon a knuckle. A trochanter is a kind of like a huge epicondyle. A trochanter is a very large bump for muscle attachment. It is larger than either a tubercle or tuberosity, both of which we'll look at in a moment. Trochanter literally means runner. A tuberosity is an oblong raised bump, usually for muscle attachment. It may also be called a tuber. A small tuberosity is called a tubercle. The word part tuber literally means bump or lump. Here are a couple tubercles. A tubercle is a small tuberosity, that is a small oblong bump. Tubercle literally means small bump or small lump. A foramen, or foramen, is a rounded hole for vessels and nerves. The plural of foramen is foramina. A meatus is like a foramen, but is more tube-like, forming an elongated opening or channel. The plural of meatus is the same as the singular form, meatus, or you can say meatuses. Meatus literally means passage. A long crack-like hole, a kind of split in the bone, to allow blood vessels and nerves to pass through, is called a fissure. And lastly, one that you probably already know. A sinus is a cavity or hollow space within a bone, such as any of the large sinuses found in some of the skull bones. Where can you find a list of these skeletal descriptive terms and their meanings and examples of each one? One source is my Survival Guide for Anatomy and Physiology. You'll find a lot more shortcuts there too. Another place to look is my online web guide to human anatomy and physiology, where you can download a free list of these terms. For more videos, shortcuts, tips, and practical advice for learning human structure and function, visit theapstudent.org and sign up for the free newsletter.